Shai Wasner is with us. Mozart's 15th Piano Concerto at Heinz Hall with the Pittsburgh Symphony and Raphael of Rubeck de Burgos. Mr. Wasner, Jim Cunningham, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Good to meet you. Thank you. Thanks
welcome,
for having me.
Welcome. Welcome. Your debut with the Pittsburgh Symphony.
Sure, I guess so. Yeah.
At last. It's great. The 15th Piano Concerto by Mozart. Mozart said it was the 15th and the 16th were really tough, but the B-flat major makes you sweat. It's really, really hard.
It is, yeah. I mean, he must have been very proud of it, too. He wrote it for himself. And it's interesting to sort of look at that period in his life, in his creative life, because he had just started a catalog of his pieces with the previous concerto, with the preceding concerto, 449. Is the first piece that he put in the catalog, which is, I think, quite mind-boggling when you come to think of, you know, the amazing masterpieces that were already there and just simply, you know, didn't even get into the catalog. So you have this, you know, series of you know, the great concertos. I mean, there are many great ones from before, but, you know, traditionally, the ones from this period on are considered the great ones that he wrote for himself mostly. And it's really just, you know, it's staggering. It was just like one masterpiece after the other, and they're all equally great. They're all equally interesting, and yet they each has its own character. It's really, can't think of anything like it. Really,
Mozart always wrote wonderful things for the winds too, and we really hear the winds to great effect in this concerto.
Yes, I think that's really one of the first ones, if not the first one, that sort of brings them to the fore, if you will, and gives them, you know, real important stuff to do. Yeah.
First impression of the Pittsburgh Symphony?
Well, I can't say it's first impression because I've heard them before. It's such a fabulous orchestra. It's such a treat to play with them. You know, we just had a rehearsal and they're obviously amazing. I'm not telling you anything new.
And Maestro Rubeck de Burgos, probably the most famous living Spanish conductor, one of the most famous in the business.
Yes, yes, yes. That's also a treat. I mean, you know, he's been around for a long time, and he's worked with everybody, and he's done so much, and he has such incredible experience. It's a real privilege, absolutely.
We have been blessed in Pittsburgh over many seasons to have Emmanuel Ax as a regular guest, and he was important to your early career.
Yes, yes. I was fortunate to be his student at Juilliard for, 4 years, although I still see myself as his student. I mean, whenever we meet, when we talk about music, and I always, always, always learn something. And I'm extremely, extremely fortunate to, you know, to have this relationship. And he was really the reason for me to move to this country, because, you know, that was when I started to study with him. And you know, I'm forever grateful for that opportunity.